Okay, so let's get started. Yes, I want to talk about the recent rumor that's been going around, and that is that it's come to my, come to my attention that the AEW might be signing Tessa Blanchard, and I think that's an awful fucking mistake. I don't think AEW actually really needs her. I don't think AEW needs her, nor her husband. What's his name? I think his name Wadaka. I don't think AEW needs her husband either. I don't know. I just feel like really weird about this because there's been so many like people that say that she's like a backstage bully and that she's a bit of a racist. I believe all of that. The only person that has said that they did none of this was Tessa, but everybody else that was there when she called that one wrestler a derogatory name for a person of color, and spat in her face. So as everybody pretty much said that happened except for her. So I tend to believe everybody else, because if they said that happened and that they were there to witness that, then I believe them. So I think that Tessa is like just one big fat fucking liar. And I don't trust her. She is she, like I said, she just has like so many like attitude problems, and I don't mean to say it, but like I think she's kind of a bitch behind the scenes, if I'm being honest with you, like according to a lot of reports. And I think that was the main reason why WWE didn't sign her. It had like a lot to do with with the fact that like her ex-boyfriend Ricochet is on there, and I guess he broke up with her at one point in time, like a few years ago, and she would show up at the performance center almost kind of like, it's kind of been an alleged kind of situation, but she would just like storm the place where he was training, and was like trying to get in his face, and it was like yelling and crying and screaming and like cussing him out and shit like that. And when I heard that, I was like, oh, okay, well, I'm not really surprised that they didn't sign her. I mean, because she's fucking crazy. So I wouldn't be surprised if she did some of the like the political stuff backstage, if Tony ever signs her, for contract for, for AEW Dynamite. I can't say that I would be surprised if she did the same thing. And but also she was a total diva, of like backstage over on Impact Wrestling. They said she was a nightmare, so it's just one of those things where there's just been so much like like dirt like on her that I think at this point they're pretty much only signing her because her father is on there, and he's a part of the Pinnacle faction. I have a feeling that if her dad wasn't on Dynamite, I don't think that they would sign her. But that's just me. That's just my honest opinion. But let me know in the comments section, down below what you guys think. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. If I'm right, well then. Tell me about it, or let's have a discussion. I'm ready to talk about this. Let's talk. I just want to talk. So yeah, but then she held hold the title hostage at one point. Like she was stuck in Mexico and did not want to deliver the belt back to the company. I was like, wow, that's really mean spirited. I just can't imagine. Like, so yeah, I have a feeling that she's gonna be a nightmare to work with, for AEW also. So, I just don't think that they need that kind of press. I thought AEW was better than this. I thought AEW was better than that. Shouldn't you save this shit for like WWE? Shouldn't she be on NXT or something? I just don't really understand. Well, I guess I was wrong. I guess AEW isn't better than that. Whatever. Yeah, AEW, do better. Well, as always, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Okay, bye.